So this is the definitive cheat sheet for the physics G final. I think 1, 2, and 5 are SUVAT, aren't they? Not SUVAT, but we call them something else, right? But they're just kinematics formulas, right? And so for number 1 and number 2 and number 5, right, there's things we can know. We can know delta x, the initial velocity, the final velocity, the acceleration, the time. I guess that spells xvact or something like that, right? Okay, then we have formulas. We've got that the velocity, average velocity, is delta x over t. We've got acceleration is change in velocity over time. We've got that displacement is 1/2 the initial velocity plus the final velocity times time. We've got the displacement is the initial velocity times time plus 1/2 at squared. And then finally that the final velocity squared is the initial velocity squared plus 2x. Yeah. And I think we quit using the deltas because x just means change in x. Yeah. So that's 1, 2, and 5. And then number 3 and number 4, those had to do with forces, right? So F equals MA, right? But this force really is the sum of all the forces, right? It's F1 plus or minus F2 plus or minus F3. Yeah?
Hi, what's an example of an organism's niche and habitat?
A niche and a habitat.
What now?
It's like a treasure hunt. How about there's a bat in South America that eats fish. And its niche is that it eats fish, and its habitat is someplace where there's fish, South America. You didn't get that part, right? Okay. I've been giving that example a lot. I think that's a great example. Okay, so... So if there's like, for example, if there's a force in opposition to you, by the way, the answer to 3B is wrong. I got that wrong. I think Natalie got it right, but then I changed it and then I got it wrong. Sad. Thank Natalie. She got the answers to these. Yeah. Yeah, there you go. Okay, the other thing we need to know is that there's two other forces. There's the force of gravity is M times G, right? So the weight. And G is, of course, our friend 9.8 newtons per kilogram. Also, that the force of friction, if you're dragging something, is mu times M times G, right? It's mu times the weight. And then for number six, you're going to need momentum is mass times velocity. Right, then you also need to know the notion of, you know, M plus V, or M times V equals M times V plus M times V kind of a thing, right? And then there's also, and it's not on here, but there's one of those force times time is mass change in velocity type problems on there. There's one of those, like I think a rocket problem or something, so you might want to look at that. And that is 6, and then 7 is you got to do the force of gravity, right? M1, M2 over R squared, right? And then there's all those formulas for like orbit problems that we should know, right? So there's MV squared over R is GMM over R squared. And this is one of these masses is the central body mass. Remember that if I give you a planet and a moon, right, that it's the small mass that's going to cancel. The moon is both going around the planet and also accelerating. It's one of these masses, and it's the mass that has that velocity, right? So that mass cancels, right? And then you could also do m for pi squared r over t squared, right? Right, and again, this mass is going to cancel. This is for number 7, yeah. And then number eight. For number eight, I think we need to know the Hubble. B is HD. And I think we need to know that the change in wavelength is to the wavelength as the velocity is to the speed of light.
Hi.
Hi.
Can I speak to Jen Stein?
Yes, you can. Are you going to treat her nicely?
Yes, I will.
Okay, good. Right, and then let me just double check what other formulas I might consult. I don't know, I might have clairvoyant powers and be able to tell you what other formulas we need on the... Actually, you know what I can do? I can go up here and look at this. I'm looking at the online site. So again, that site is IB Solutions. Not IB Solutions, sorry. G Solutions. And study for the final there. It's the last one. Right? Okay, parsecs to light years. Right? So you need to know that one megaparsec is 1 times 10 to the 6th parsecs, right? Then you need to know that 1 parsec is 3.26 light years. That's handy, right? Calculate the Hubble constant here. So in that one, you calculate the Hubble constant. Here you're going to calculate, I believe, the distance to it, right? Calculate the wavelength. Calculate parallax. So the distance is 1 over the parallax angle. Yeah, we've done that one. Question about the rotation of planets. That's enigmatic, the rotation of planets. Should I be more specific about the rotation of planets? I think I should, don't you think? Yeah, because that's very vague. Rotation of planets? Let me consult something. Oh, that's crazy. Yeah, it has to do with the planets and why they lie on the same plane. Why do the planets all lie? Why do scientists think that the eight planets? That's right. All right. All right. All right, that's the ultimate cheat sheet.